Hi, welcome to Painting with Aaron. Today I'm going to paint a bowl of fruit. This is a classic still life, so that's why I chose it. Now, the first thing I do when I'm doing a painting is make the palette. Now, this once you make the palette, it's pretty much easy from there, I figure. So, let's look at it. We're painting a bowl of fruit. There's definitely a banana. I'm going to put some yellow in. Now, this isn't the exact yellow of the banana, but I can lighten and darken it as I see. There's also an apple, so definitely some green. Now, I'm putting a lot of paint out here. You probably won't use all this paint, but it's good to have for mixing, and you're going to mess up and make some wrong colors, so I usually end up wasting a lot of paint, but, you know, can't get upset about that. Also, some white is going to help make different tints on each of the colors. White is an essential in every painting, practically. So I'm going to put some white there. There's some very red tomatoes. So here we got some red. These are oil paints, by the way, and they're about $6 a piece, $12 at some places. And oil paints are different from acrylic paints because they dry much slower. So you'll be able to go into your painting a day after you're done and still alter the paint. So here I have a little tube of orange. Put that in there. I can also mix red and yellow to make orange for the oranges or tangerines or whatever they are. Okay, let's see what else we have. There's definitely some brown in both the table and this nut on the left. So let's put some brown in there. And I'm putting all the paints kind of like far away from each other on the palette so that I have room to mix the colors in between in the blank space. What else? Well, you usually need black in every painting to make lights and darks, so definitely black. But a lot of people, you know, once you add a little bit of black, it tends to dominate the painting. So you have to use black very sparingly. Sometimes if you want to make a dark color, instead of using black, you can use like blue or purple so that the whole color doesn't turn to black. So that tends to happen. Okay, let's see what else we got. We have the orange, we have the apple, we have some type of nuts that are found around Santa Cruz, the banana, the tomatoes with the red, and the apple with the green. And it looks like there's some red in the apple too. Okay. So, first thing I'm going to do is I'm making my paints thinner with this terpenoid product. So that makes the paint more manageable and softer, easier to work with. So I'm just going to use some terpenoid and just sketch out the placement of the figures in my canvas, which I have chosen. This is a canvas board, by the way. I like it because it's light and portable, and you can use it. So I think the banana, remember, this is just to kind of get the shapes. The first thing we're going to do is just get where the shapes are using this clear liquid, just so you're not inhibited at all, because this isn't going to be any color. Okay, there's the banana in the middle. I'd like it to be a little smaller. Okay, then let's see. There's some tomatoes. There's a circle. So when you're painting a banana or anything, try to just identify a shape. Like, the banana is a curve, okay? And it's the top of the curve is facing up directly. Actually, a little to the right, so it goes like that. Okay, so then the tomato is obviously a circle. There's three of them in a row. Two, three. Here's an apple next to the banana. Here's an orange in kind of the foreground. There's that nut. And then here's the bowl. So the bowl starts, like, from my point of view, the edge of the bowl comes right out of the middle of the third tomato. Okay? And it goes into the bottom of the top tomato. Then the bottom of the bowl kind of, let's see, it looks like that's going out a little too much. So the bottom of the bowl kind of goes like that. We have this orange in the foreground, which is only going to be half in my painting. And we have this apple right here above the orange, and that's only going to be a little bit of it is going to be in the painting. that nut over there to the left of the orange. Let's see, is that even going to make it in my painting? Yeah, about right there. Okay, so we have the basic shapes. Now, thing that stops you from painting is you don't want to mess up and you don't want to do a bad painting. So you just have to go for it, okay? Don't let, this isn't the right color yellow, it doesn't matter, you know? You don't have yellow, it's okay. Use white, use pink, whatever. Let's just do it. Okay, so there's that shape. It's a moon shape. Let's see, about right there. Okay, looks good. And then there's the lower banana. There's two bananas in the bowl. Good. Now this is the lightest lights of the banana. So when I come in later, after I put in my initial forms, this will be the lights, and maybe I'll add a little blue or green to the yellow a tiny bit and put in the shading of the banana, but I won't worry about that right now. I'll clean my brush and the terpenoid and then just kind of swab it on an old rag. Tomatoes. Okay, so I have a slightly thin red here. I have a lot of red paint on my palette. Okay, the tomato comes out of the top of the banana. That's a really nice red. Like that. And let's see, it looks a little big to me. Oh well. There's a smaller tomato right there. And there's another tomato right there. So let's see. To keep your painting from getting too far from reality, just look at the relationships between the objects. Like, for example, I see that the tomato on the far right, if I drop a line down from the right edge of it, it goes about to the end of the banana. Actually, a little less than that. So I can make the banana a little bigger, but the tomato looks like it's right, maybe right there instead. Okay, good. What else? The orange. Very prominent in the foreground. I'm just using the colors I have right now. I'm not even worrying about mixing them to get the exact right color. But I am going to do that a little bit with this orange because it looks to be much darker just by comparing the brush to the tangerine. So let's see. I have two options to lighten it, yellow and white. I'm going to try yellow first. We'll see what happens. See if that makes it more like the tangerine in my picture. Okay, I've now mixed. See, that's a slightly darker, lighter color. It's not perfect. It's not even close. Let's try a little white, and if that doesn't work, we're just going to go with what we got. Okay, this is a different kind of orange. It's closer. It's not perfect. It's okay. So let's see. The top of this orange starts at about right under the stem of the banana, under that one, and in between these two guys. And let's see where it lands on the banana, too. Just the left edge of the orange is a little to the left, is about a little left of center in the whole placement of the bowl, from my perspective. Okay. Now that is not the right orange at all, I can tell that. It's okay though. It needs to be a little lighter. These tomatoes need to be a little darker. Let's move on. And the one thing that I definitely wanted to say in this program that helps me paint and not be like inhibited because it's going to turn out looking horrible is that people aren't interested in what the fruit looks like. They know what fruit looks like. They're interested in your impression of the fruit. So if you see an orange and it looks like a big orange circle, you know, that's what it is. Don't worry if it's like slightly not whatever. They're interested in your impression of the fruit. So there's a whole movement called the Impressionist movement where people stop trying to draw, like, stop trying to make their painting look like real life and just said, you know, we'll try to work in some our impressions of what life is like. It was big in about the 1800s or something. And I think it kind of coincided with the advent of photography, because once you could photograph a bowl of fruit, then what's the point of painting a perfect bowl of fruit? So that gives us a lot of leeway. No one expects it to look good, look perfect and realistic. They do expect it to look good, though. All right, here's a light green, should be much lighter. So just by holding up the green and holding it next to the apple I'm painting, I saw that this is like a candy apple, and that's almost, I mean, that's yellow, lighter yellow than the banana. Okay. So I'm going to get some yellow on the brush, a little bit, and just mix it with some green and see if I get a color that resembles the apple in front of me. How's that look? Not great. Much better, though. I'm going with it. So I can see the curve of the apple starts at about the middle of the orange and then arcs upward like that into about the same height level in my view as the banana. So curve to the banana. That's what I saw. That's what I'm doing. So let me just fill this in. Now all this space isn't green here, but I'm going to paint over it. I'm just putting this in so that when the colors I paint over it will mix well with that color. Like there's splotches of red in the apple, so I'll just take some red and mix it in a little bit later. Okay. Oh, there's also this apple. So once you have color on your brush, try to paint everything that color on the canvas. Okay? Then you don't have to go back and forth and back and forth. So if I got a green here, I look anywhere else in my still life or whatever I'm painting for any other of that same green, and I put it in while I have the paint on my brush. So, looks like that apple is about one step to the right of the edge of the bowl and about two steps down. It's about that shape. It's just a very rough estimate. It just gets me started. So the edge of the bowl doesn't go the whole width of this tomato away from it. It goes about half the width of the tomato. So it goes to about there. The apple goes about one, two. Right there. It's okay. Total estimate. I'm sure it'll look fine. I should have painted that other orange when I had orange on my paint, on my brush. And I'll do that now. Another thing when painting, advice that I've learned from painting, which hasn't been that long, but as soon as you think of anything that would make your painting better, put it in. As soon as you think of it. So this is the dark orange. And when I'm looking at my still life right now, I see that the orange in the foreground is a little bit darker than the orange behind it that's in the bowl. So this is the unaltered orange out of my tube of paint. I'm just going to put it on. It almost goes to the height of the apple. It goes about halfway up the apple is the height. So maybe that apple is a little too high. Boom. Okay. And it almost goes to the edge of the bowl too, so let's raise it up a little bit. Remember, this is just the first stage. We're just getting the colors in there. After we get kind of all the white space filled up, we're going to come back and develop. Okay. Oh, there's also some more orange I noticed behind this orange. There's an orange behind there, just a tiny little peak of it next to the nut. So I'm going to mix this orange, make it a tiny bit darker. Should put some blue out here because blue is good. Blue is a good color to mix with any color to make it darker because it, instead of using black, which just kind of kills it and turns it completely black, it gives it some color. So just a tiny bit of blue. This blue I have, I think it's called cerulean blue. It's very powerful blue. So we'll see how powerful it is. I'm going to dip my brush in the turpentine to thin this up. Okay. That's pretty dark, definitely dark enough for behind that orange. So this is just two small shapes. One triangle to the right of the orange and a tiny little triangle above to the right of the orange above that other triangle. Boom. And then there's this other triangle, tiny. Okay. While I have this dark orange here, I'm just gonna throw it into the orange right here to put some shading. So when you're shading, here's the thing I've learned about how do you know what's dark and what's light. Squint your eyes. This is super important. Squinting your eyes is really helpful of just to separate darks and lights. So when I squint my eyes right now, I look at the orange, I see two white dots in the middle of it, and then I see the upper left side of it is dark. Okay? So I'm just gonna, I have this dark orange on my palette, on my brush. While I have it here, I might as well use it, so I kind of see this dark. Okay, kind of like that. About that shape. A little too much, it's okay. This other orange, we can use this dark orange too while we have it. I'm squinting at it right now. I see definitely some white glare. Beyond that, it looks basically one color except the bottom half of it is a little darker. So put in some orange there. Okay, what else do we have? The nut to the right of the orange. So here's my brown. Let's see how close that comes. That's pretty good. That's about the color of it. I'll put in the shading later. I'm just gonna, so that this nut comes from the bottom of the tomato, hits the orange, goes to the bottom of the banana, kind of like that. Okay? And the other nut in the picture is to the left of the tangerine slash orange in the foreground, and about directly below the edge of the bowl, at about the same level as the middle of the orange, so right there. Okay, good. Next thing, look at all this space. Oh yeah, let's do the bowl now. So we're gonna etch in the bowl real quickly, then we'll fill up all this white space, then we'll come back in and try to make this thing look good. Okay, so I have this brown, okay, I'm gonna do the bowl right now. So I have all the pieces of fruit definitely represented, and then there's the bowl. Now I'm looking at the bowl to try to see what color it is. It's clear. I definitely see streaks of white. So let's get some white on my brush. Okay. So where are the lines of white? Well, there's one arc coming from the bottom of this tomato, and that circles all, it kind of runs right along the edge of the bananas and goes right under and goes about to right there. So let's just, that's not white, that's brown. Because I'm not great at cleaning my brushes, so a lot of the times it's hard to get pure colors. Okay, so boom, white, white. Where else is white? Got white on my brush. Everywhere there's white, now's the time to do it. So, let's see, there's some white right there. White right there. Okay. There's two parallel arcs. One runs parallel to this one. Okay, looks like there's some white right here. Now I'm not painting in white here. This is actually, looks like, I don't know, some kind of walnut or off-white. But you know, I'm not gonna take the time to look for a perfect white. You just go with what you got, don't stall, or you'll never finish it. That's the one thing I've learned. Okay, good. All right, so now let's put in the darks of the bowl. So this is how I think about painting objects. Simplest way, when painting any object, there's going to be lights and darks, and that's what you break your object down to. There's going to be the lightest lights, so I'll make some really light red and when I color the tomatoes, and then there's going to be the darkest darks, so I'll make some darker red and put in the dark areas. And I don't really, much beyond that, beyond a three-color spectrum for one object, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to go for about three colors. Regular color of the fruit, the light color, the light part, and the dark part. Okay, So now we're going to work on the darks of the bowl. Now, the darks contain the brown of the table in the background. So I want brown, not total brown, maybe it's kind of a lighter brown. Because definitely the part of the table I see through the bowl is lighter than the table. So let's see. Goes about to there. Looks, I think it should be a little darker than that when I'm looking at it now. It's definitely darkest right under the banana. I shouldn't use black, but I'm gonna use a touch of black. You wanna kinda keep away from using black because it's so powerful, but as soon as you add it into like a color, you know, any meaningful amount of paint added, black paint added to your color, it's just gonna turn it black. Okay, darker than that. Okay, so there's the black. Now, I put that in, I was looking at the area right under the bottom banana of the bowl. Okay, let's get this black paint off here. And get some brown. This is gonna be the colors of the bowl. So where are their dark colors? Forget brown. Okay, so this brown was for the part of the bowl where you could see the table through the bowl. The other darks in the bowl look to me like a dark blue. When I'm looking at the edge of the bowl and when I'm looking at kind of the shape of the bowl where it comes out right before the top, the lip, it looks like dark blue to me. So let's clean off the brush and get some dark blue. I'm going to use this powerful blue. This blue is very powerful, cerulean blue. But you know, it comes in a little tube, and the blue that comes in a big tube is probably a normal color. So let's see, is that blue right? No, it looks a little more turquoise, or at least a little lighter. So let's add a little white. Why not add a little green? I have it right there. All right, add a little terpenoid to thin it up so that it comes off on the canvas. It's soft. So let's see, how's that? That's definitely turquoise. Should be a little darker. Added a touch of black. Okay, good enough. So where are these dark blue lines? There's one that comes under the orange, and where's it? It runs from all the way here. Goes all the way under the orange and then kind of comes in and out about this part. So, comes right out here. Runs right under the orange, under the banana. Okay. And then there's another line that goes right here. Where's this up that goes below the blue line I just painted? Okay. Okay, and there's some white over there that on this side, and I'll put that in a second. And then what's going on here? Looks like there's some dark. What about, where else does this blue show up? This dark blue that I'm seeing in the glass. Oh, I don't know really. This could be dark blue, this could be brown. Blue should be okay. Maybe a little darker. Okay. All right. Not, nowhere close to perfect. It's okay. Okay. Now I'm just trying to fill. I'm about to just color the backgrounds behind the fruit, just some general colors with some texture in it. Probably a dark color to represent the table. I just want to fill in all the space within the fruit bowl first. So right there. Right here on my painting, where you can see the table behind the glass, I'm going to put in that light brown I was working with earlier. Is that light brown? It's light brown or blue or something, I'm not sure. A little lighter than that. Okay, because I decided to make it lighter than I had it, because I noticed that this nut was definitely darker than the part of the table you saw in here. And even though this was the color brown, it's when I'm looking at it, this stands out very much. So I have to make it darker and make it stand out from the background. There's that brown. I don't know what that is, but right here there's a little hole between the tomatoes where you can see the table. Right here, just looking for patches of this color brown, which is the color of the table through the bowl. Okay, cool. All right, so before, that spot is filled up with red. Okay. Tomatoes meet there. All right, let's put in some background. So that we can, I like to put in the background before, you know, I go any more in depth into my fruit, just to get it over with, you know, get it finished as soon as possible, what have you. So this is a brown table behind it, and it looks like the edge of the table. Usually I kind of like it when the edge of the table is about right there, and so half it's white, half of it is light, and half it's dark. But the whole thing behind the fruit is dark, so this is all a no-brainer. It's all just going to be kind of a weird off-brown, whatever I choose. I don't want it to be darker than the stuff in the foreground. That's one thing. You don't want your background to overshadow your foreground. So that's why you never need to spend a lot of time on the background. Because if you did, it might be overshadowing it. So let's just put this in. Fill in the corners. Yeah. Okay. Get some terpenoid on the brush so that it flows on easily. I'm just filling in space right here. There's lines in the table, which I can add later. I'm not overly concerned with it. And let's see, does the background get lighter or darker in any case? Well, there's a slight shadow of the bowl to the left. Beyond that, it really looks about the same color brown to me. So. Just filling in brown here. A little red got into the brown. It's okay. It's good. It'll make it better. I like to paint with music on in the background because basically the thing that stops me from painting is I get bored, or the thing that stops me from doing anything that I should be doing, or, you know, it's getting bored. So make painting as little boring as possible. Okay, just filling this in as quick as possible. Boom, boom, boom. There's that red swirling around there. It's pretty thin paint right here because I mixed it with the terpenoid. Okay, so now we finished step one. Let's see, I'm going to make some directional lines that reflect the table right here because there's lines in the wood of the table, so I'll represent that. Good. Step one complete. Doesn't look good at all. It's okay. Step two, I like to just go in the same order I did step one. I'll do each object, I'll break it down into lights and darks, and add in some minor details. So, first thing I did when I started this painting was draw the arc of the banana. Now I'm coming back to the banana. Okay, so let's make a darker yellow, because this yellow I'm looking at, there's many shades in it. There's the light yellow, which is kind of this top region, Then it looks like when I'm squinting, remember squint to tell the difference between lights and darks. It'll clarify it for you. So when I squint, I see this is kind of dark yellow. Dark yellow, dark yellow. Okay, so I'll take my yellow. So this brush is saturated with yellow paint. I have a couple options. I can mix this yellow with black. I can mix it with blue, purple, anything. I'm just going to try to mix it with the tiniest, tiniest touch of blue. Any bit too much. I just have barely any on there. We'll see how much it affects it. Whoops. Okay, let's check out the color we got here. I like it. Looks good.
Go away from my window. Leave at your own chosen speed. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'm not the one you need.
Okay, so there's the dark yellow. Now remember, they're not interested in the fruit, whoever the person is that might be looking at it. We're interested in your impression of the fruit, so don't get hung up when it doesn't look like real life. It's not supposed to. It's supposed to look like what you think a banana looks like. Okay, so there's some dark. Where else is there dark yellow? I definitely saw that shading under the bright yellow, and I noticed that the dark yellow runs about parallel to this lower line. So I didn't really have to worry about the shape of the dark yellow. I could just paint it in comparison with the marks I already have on my painting. There's like a shadow right here. I don't know. Put that in. Dark right there at the end of the banana. Okay. You say you're banana has many more facets, a lot more information to convey. So we just put in some dark yellow. We have our light yellow, which I'm going to touch up real quickly. Goes about right like that. Whoops. There's the light yellow. Runs right down to about there, under the orange. The orange, the rim of the bowl, and the edge of the banana all meet at this point. Okay, so there's some yellow. The light, I'm putting in the yellow light, the light yellow, one more time. Okay. Okay, look at the top of the banana. It's, looks like a light brown, the part that I guess you rip off the tree or whatever. So first I'm going to get brown on my brush. There's definitely some brown in that banana. When I painted this banana a couple days ago, it was completely yellow, so that's interesting. How's that brown in comparison? You know what? It should be a little darker brown. So I'm going to mix the tiniest amount of black. I don't want to lose the brown completely. A little bit more black. Yeah, black is a powerful color. Whenever you're in a jam and like, oh, I can't get the edge of the apple to show, you know, you can always come back to black. It'll help you out. It's strong. It overrides all the other colors. Okay, so then now I'm going to put in the brown spots of the banana. This one right here. Looks like there's kind of a big one right there. Just putting in shapes. Every shape is basically just, you know, simple. Don't get caught up in making it perfect. I can see that the brown spot is above and below the line of the bowl right there. There's definitely some brown there, and there's some even black, you know, right in the middle of the brown. Some of it's brown, some of it's black. So let's put touches of black in here. Where else is there black? There's a spot of black right there. Not that much, but there's some. There's some. So I'm just looking anywhere I can see black on the banana, now's the time to put it in. I'm not going to come back later. This is all the time of black paint with the banana. So you just got to put it in everywhere. It's around the rim of the top of the banana. Okay, That's a good amount of black. Dip the brush in turpentine. And let's get some brown back, because I didn't quite finish up with the brown. Here's the brown on the second banana behind it. Some dots of brown. There are no dots of brown there. I was mistaken. Okay, the dots were here. Okay. Let's do the light brown on top of the banana. So I already have brown on my brush. I'll mix it with a little bit of white. Okay. Not the perfect color. Should be much whiter, huh? Okay. That banana I've spent enough time on for now. Go into the next. Go into the apple right next to it. This apple has the shadow of the orange on it. So if you look at the apple, coming about from the middle of the orange to about there, there's an arc, which is the shadow of the orange. So I'm definitely going to want a kind of darker color here. So I basically just use one brush when doing a painting, just to keep it simple. Maybe two brushes if you have like a light brush and a dark brush, but one brush just makes a lot less decisions to make. Okay, so that dark green that is the shadow of the orange, it's a little light with my light green, so let's make that apple, since this is the time to touch up the apple, let's put some yellow in there because I just think it's yellower. And since the paint is still soft, I can just go back, put yellow on my brush, and it will mix with the green that's already there because it's still wet. Okay. Then, didn't make it much yellower. Huh, how's that? That's good. I like it. Okay, so now let's go with the dark. Let's make the darker green for the shadow. Mix it with some green. How's that for that color? I somehow think it should be yellow mixed with black for that shadow. So let's just put a tiny bit of black on the brush and see if we can just do it. Okay. It's a lot of black. I don't want to have too much black on. Okay. So there's this arc. And there's the shadow. And also, if you look, there's red in that apple. So that's going to make the apple more interesting. Just put a little bit of red on my brush. See if we can just sneak it in there. Whoops. Not subtle enough. Okay. This paint I'm using is real thin. Sometimes you have to, you add too much turpentine and you lose the ability to put on the paint thickly. Okay. What happened to the red? All right. It's about like that. And then there's some red over there. And there's, I don't know whether that's a shadow or whether I'm just imagining it, but I kind of see some darkness at the other edge of the apple. Okay. So we're still working on the apple. And basically I'm just going around to all these shapes and I'm putting in the lightest lights and the darkest darks. Okay, so there's really light, it's kind of subtle, in the middle of the apple, or the top of the apple, middle top of the apple. Does that white carry through? Yeah, there's a spot of white too in the dark zone. Great. That'll help the apple look like one object more instead of kind of miscellaneous. and it gets dark down there. Okay. Wow, I am not really happy with that apple right now. I'm gonna move on though. Okay, we got the three tomatoes to work on. So instead of being three objects, just it'll kind of be one object. We'll put in all the lights of it, all the darks of it. All right, we have a blank brush here. Let's kind of move this paint around. Finalize the shapes a little. Well, the hives are gone. I lost my bees. Chickens are sleeping in the willow trees. Cows in water up past. So I'm just putting in the shapes again. Okay. So there's the red. There's definitely red in all three of those tomatoes. Some of them have lights and darks. They all have lights and darks. Some have more darks than others. So the first thing, the easiest thing to do, the first thing I think, is look at all those white spots. There's like 10 lights in the studio, and a bunch of them are represented in the apple. So I'm trying to get basically white on my brush. So this is pure white, basically. Okay, first tomato right here. There's two twin dots, one dot a little low and one a little above. One, twin dots, kind of a bigger one right there, and then kind of another one right there. What about this one next to it? Three dots in a row and kind of a pyramid formation. So here's the bottom of the pyramid. Here's the top of the pyramid. What about this one? There's another triplet, which I'll basically just put as a large blob because I can't really differentiate with the size of this brush how little those things are. Then here's some light. Okay, so that's the white. Okay, where else is there light? Where is the light red in these tomatoes? I'm gonna do the light red, I'm gonna do the dark red. There's a whole, this whole side is kind of light red of that tomato. Big white spot. Now I'm squinting my eyes to find out the lights and darks. So besides these bright white dots, there's no, I don't really see that. It's dark right there. There's definitely light on the edge. What else? So I'm just squinting my eyes, looking at all three tomatoes, trying to put in colors. Put in the lights right now. Okay. Let's go to the dark part of the tomato. Okay. So I put in too much black on my brush. I had to clean it off because it was just a lost cause. There was too much black and it would turn anything black. Okay. That's a dark red. Let's see how, if that red is contained in the tomatoes. Not really. I'm not really seeing it. It looks like a totally different type of red. Huh. But it's dark red, so it's good enough. It's definitely darker than the red of the tomato, and that's its important function to differentiate. Okay, so let's start in the middle tomato. This has some serious darks. The dark of the tomato next to it, shadowing it, there's just a big dark spot, dark border. Okay. And it's dark all over here too. The shadow of the apple is right there. It's dark right there too. I don't know what that's the shadow of, but it's dark. And then there's a dark line on the edge. There's a dark line here. Is that a dark line? I'm squinting. It seems to get darker. There seems to be white on the very edge and dark right before that white on the very edge of the tomatoes. It's dark down here for sure. So I'm just putting in lights and darks as I see them. I'm not really worrying about what my tomato looks like. When I'm all done doing this, I'll step back. If it looks good, that's great. If it doesn't, I'll keep on going. But I'm not worrying about how it looks right now. I'm just worrying about getting dark red represented. So there's definitely dark right there. Okay. Well, there's dark surrounding this whole piece of light. Okay. I'm just going to ignore the sticker for now because I don't want to deal with it. But it seems like kind of this whole, the sticker on the third tomato, on the rightmost tomato. Not going to worry about it right now. Because it would slow me down. I'd have to get green on my brush and deal with it. I don't want to be doing that. Okay. So how those tomatoes look? Let's see. Let's look at each of them and see if they each have the darks of them and the lights of them are represented in my painting. First one, it's got two white dots and a dark side and the dark lower side and the dark upper side. Check, there's the two white dots, there's some dark, maybe a little more dark like that. I'm squinting again to see the lights and darks. Okay, this has kind of the whole circle, you can see the circle of the fruit next to it. Or vegetable. Okay. Okay, and another thing I just noticed, so I'm going to do it right now, because I noticed it, I do it as soon as I notice it, is the string of white on the tops of the tomatoes. The arc, the white arc that is clearly visible on all three tomatoes. So let's see, here's one. Check. Two. That's a little overpronounced, but check. Number three. Let's get a little more white on the brush, because the paint's turned to red from the contact with the wet paint on the canvas. And check. Okay, orange in the middle of the bowl. We got a head start on this when I put in the dark orange up to one side, so that's good. Even less work than I thought. So the easiest thing to do to start out is to get the two white dots in the middle of the orange. I noticed them first thing I noticed, so it's the first thing I'm going to paint. My white paint is kind of losing it. It's getting too mixed with other colors. Yeah, that should be fine. Let's mix it with some. Okay. So there's two white circular objects right in the middle. One. Two. There's another one right here. Above it. Check. Oh look, there's some gleam right here on this other orange. Kind of like that. That other orange is getting lost now. It's definitely got some light, some white. Okay. Now I'm squinting hard. I'm seeing the dark orange here that I saw earlier. I'm seeing the two white dots. What else am I seeing? I'm seeing a couple dark dots, but they're just dots. I'll put those in. And I'm gonna put in some lighter orange too, try to get closer to that, the color of the tangerine. So I'll take the orange. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. Okay, there's the orange that I have that came with, that I had bought a long time ago. Definitely lighter. Because you're mine, I want the line. So I'm mixing yellow. It's not at all helpful. It's just disappearing as soon as I mix it. So instead of mixing yellow with the orange, I'll take just the orange on the brush and put it with some yellow. I'm mixing with yellow because red and yellow make orange, so that's the spectrum I'm working with. So I start out with dark orange, I mix with yellow. I hope it'll get closer to yellow. It's still just a weird kind of orange. I mean, that's a different orange for sure than the orange I have. So I'll tinker with it a little more. If I can't get it, you know, then the tangerine will be incorrectly represented in my painting. Okay, it's not realistic. All right, so there's the light orange. Ew, I don't like that orange. Can't be better. So right now I'm thinking, what could I do to make this orange on my brush more like the orange in the tangerine? I tried yellow. I think I'm gonna try it again. A lot of yellow. Okay, there's a lot of yellow. Anything, any headway? No. How about some white? I already tried this, but just try it again, since I'm kind of running out of ideas. Okay, going with it. It's not the perfect shade, but you don't want that to stop you from doing anything, you know? You're painting, you're not mixing paint. Okay, then there's some light on the edge of this orange here. I'm squinting. I definitely see light on the top half of the orange. Where else do I see light? Well, those three things right there. Where else is there light? Maybe a little down here. Okay, let's get that. Let's do the dark orange again.
Don't call my name out your window.
Okay. Nope, not dark enough. Let's put some blue in there, that'll be exciting.
Well,
that's definitely darker, that'll work. I want it darker. It's just, it's not contrasting with the light orange that I already have enough. So I'm mixing this strong blue with it. I'm worried I might have lost the orange completely. Okay. Well, that's definitely dark. Most important thing, not that it's the right shade, but that it's the right level of dark slash lightness. And it is. It's dark. So I'm squinting, I'm putting in dark patches as I see them. It's kind of hard to see, I don't know, you know. Ah, how's that? Let's put in this other one, as long as we got it. Yeah. It's not coming out. Great. Okay. Then there's that dark orange patches behind the orange that we could barely see.
You can give my other suit to the Salvation Army.
All right, so let's try to wrap this up. So, you know, we can finish before we get too bored. All right, so I'm going to quickly go into the, work on the nut right there. I need more brown. Okay. 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 So, brown, the nut on the rim. You know, you might be get to the stage and feel like quitting, and you know, oh, I'll come back to it later. Well, you never will, so you might as well just power it out and finish something, you know, and you'll have time to reflect on that later and do it differently next time. So I can see the brown right under the bowl there. It goes kind of like that, and that nut has some black in it. Okay. Now, almost done here. Just gonna finalize. I'm gonna put in the bowl again. And I'm gonna mix up this background a little bit too, real quick. Let's use the big brush, dip it in some black, just to break away the monotony of the background. Okay. So this is the lines of the table. I'm mixing in some black just because I noticed black in the table. Okay, let's get the borders. So I'm just very quickly putting in the borders. So I'm doing it so quickly, you think he's not doing a really good job, but then when people look at it, they're gonna go, wow, man, those brush strokes are great. I really like how you intentionally did that. And I guarantee they will say that. Okay, so now I'm looking at my finished project. I just need a couple final touches. to be happy with it. Maybe a bit of black there, a bit of dark there. Finalize the shape of this pole. Okay. So remember, this is beginning painting. It doesn't have to look good. Point is that you did it, you had fun doing it, and you might do it again. The one thing that I wanted to say more than once was they're not interested in the way that plant looks or the way whatever your painting looks. They're interested in your impression of it and how you see it. And if you, so that frees you up from trying to make it look like real life. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.